Dictation 52. Then, sir, question of prices. The prices, some people say that 15% and others say it is more. If price, then there are two aspects to be considered. What is the reason for this price rise? And what is the policy to check this price rise? So far as the reasons are concerned, generally three reasons are given. Firstly, that it is imported inflation, oil price rise. There also, I would like that the finance minister and the petroleum minister speak with one voice. We have given the figures. So far as the petroleum minister is concerned, he says the oil price rise component is only 2%, whereas the finance minister says that 26% inflation is due to oil price rise. This has to be reconciled because in answer to a question, the petroleum minister says this has a very negligible effect on the price rise. The finance minister says that it has a much bigger impact. Even on the analysis, if we agree, then what is the policy that we shall formulate? The other explanation of inflation generally given is that it is because of a poor harvest. But that question does not come in because we had good harvest. The third explanation given is hoarders and black marketeers. But with all the vast powers that the government has taken, this explanation really does not hold water. There is enormous power with the government so far as hoarders and black marketeers are concerned. The government should exert all its powers, and in this end, the entire country will be with the government. So far as price rise is concerned, there is the question of general approach to the question. So far as I recall, and the finance minister should correct me if I am wrong, he is on record as having said, my dose of inflation can be a stimulus to the economy. Whether he has said that, I do not know. But I would like to submit that in a developed country where more or less people have employment, a mild dose of inflation can be some stimulus to the economy. That may be all right. But in a poor country, if a mild dose of inflation, even 2% inflation in a year is there, it will erode the purchasing power of the people. Therefore, we must know what the government's policy on these things is. In India, if we did not have the real problem of unemployment or the problem of people living below the poverty line, then a philosophy saying that a mild dose of inflation is stimulus to the economy might be all right. But so far as India is concerned, there are some figures I have seen in the economic survey and other documents that they have given, which say that the index number of the per capita net national product in India has declined. Then, sir, I come to another important point, and that is of banking. I know the finance minister has appointed certain banks as the lead banks for all the districts in this country. I do not know what these lead banks have done. I have myself been a member of the State Planning Commission and the Development Council, and also a member of the District Development Council. I have not found any effective work being done by the lead banks. I would like the finance minister to find out if the lead banks have been able to identify the weaker sections of economy in every district, whether these lead banks have prepared any master plan for the development of their concerned districts. Whenever certain districts are entrusted to these lead banks, they must prepare a master plan for the development of the weaker sector of the district. It should be made compulsory. Have they done this work? It is more than 5 years that we have identified the banks. I would again urge upon the finance minister that he should see that the lead banks draft master plans for the development of the districts. Secondly, soft loans are provided for the weaker sections and the weaker sectors of the economy. I have seen that these banks are not at all enthusiastic. They do not show initiative in offering soft loans because they have to reimburse interest from the government afterwards, and therefore they do not go in for soft loans. I would therefore like to appeal that it should be made compulsory for the banks that the quota of soft loans earmarked for each bank for each district should be completed by the concerned bank. This has to be very particularly looked after. Then I would make another important point about energy. We have been talking about energy and energy alternatives. We have been exhausting our sources of energy. Recently, sir, I read a very important article that even China has been successful in erecting 7 million biogas plants. Why should a country which is, I should say, totally dependent upon different types of energy resources, not itself going for an alternative energy source? We have sufficient quantity of gobar gas plants. I want to make out a very subtle point. Today we propagate the gobar gas plants through khadi boards in the states and offer 25% of subsidy. I have to appeal to the finance minister that this subsidy will have to be increased in order to popularize this alternative source of energy, because the cost has increased. It has doubled now. In fact, it is much more than what I have said. At least the finance minister should see that subsidy is offered to that particular type of plant which has to be erected in the fields, farms and houses of the farmers who have 10 to 15 cattle at their disposal. Secondly, I have to request that subsidy should be provided for the propagation of instruments.
अगर आपको हमारा डिक्टेशन अच्छा लगता है, पसंद आता है, तो आप हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें, जिससे कि आने वाला नोटिफिकेशन सबसे पहले आपको मिल सके।